CPM or critical path method, how CPM is not lean. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about how the critical path method is not lean and we need to be very, very careful. And then I'm going to link you to a longer video in case you want to check it out. But let's go ahead and do this right now. If you have been exposed to the critical path method, you've probably been taught it in school, which really disappoints me, because nobody's really thought about this and how horrible and detrimental the system is. But you're in a time by deliverable format, you have your activities, they're all logic tied, and the computer will do, using an algorithm, a forward and a backward pass, and basically find the longest path, which, if any of these activities are delayed, it will delay the entire construction project. It's absolutely a horrible, horrible system, because when you do the forward and the backward pass, it scrunches everything together, it increases work in progress above the capacity of the system, and it hurts people. It doesn't have buffers. It's absolutely nonsense, because this path is a non-starter. It was never realistic, and it will be blown literally day one of the construction project. And then at the end of the schedule, the superintendent or the scheduler or the PM will simply dissolve logic and push, rush, and panic people. It's absolutely horrible. So let's talk about this. Lean in construction comes down to really six different categories. Number one is respect for people. So I'm just gonna put the acronyms here. How does CPM disrespect people? Well, it disrespects the team because you can't see it. It disrespects the trade partner because you're shoving it down their throat. And it disrespects trades because you're pushing them, trade stacking, trade burdening beyond their capacity. CPM is not lean because CPM disrespects people. Let's go to the second thing. The second concept in lean thinking is stability. And I'll just go ahead and put stability and flow. Stable system, stability, consistency, standards. That's what lean is all about. And you can't do that because you're starting so many areas, rushing, pushing, and panicking, and doing so much work in so many areas, or attempting to, that you can never finish one thing at a time. You can't be clean, you can't be safe, and you cannot be organized. And the schedule is not consistent, it's constantly moving. Therefore, CPM is not stable, and therefore, it is not lean. Let's go to the next one. Number three, lean thinking is all about one piece or one process flow, or I've actually invented a term which sounds really stupid or arrogant either way, but one progress flow, whatever you want to call it. One piece flow is manufacturing, one process flow or one progress flow is construction, right? That's where you plan something, do something, finish something, then go on to the next something, whether it's a piece, a process, or it's the progress on your construction project. CPM does not allow you to do that because it's trade stacking, trade burdening, and it's making trades start too many things at once and never finishing. It does not have a trade flow like intact. It does not crew tie, even if they say they do. Never seen it happen in thousands of schedules, maybe 400 or 500, maybe it's not thousands, but in hundreds and hundreds of schedules, never seen it, right? So CPM does not allow trades to work in one piece or one process flow, therefore it is not lean. Number four in lean thinking is working on a rhythm, or I would say flow. I'll just spell that out. That means it's okay to work in one process flow, but you have to flow together at the same speed, going the same distance apart. Because this is not in a time by location format, it can't do it, it does not have flow, it does not protect trade flow, and it does not allow a trade partner to go from zone to zone in a flow. Therefore, CPM does not comply with item number four, therefore CPM is not lean. All right, number five, and this is crucial. Total participation with everybody with visual systems. By the way, there's a rule that I learned at DPR, is however I spell it is how it's supposed to be spelled. Total participation with visual systems. You can't see the logic as human beings. You can't understand it on one page. Trade partners can't read it. Most of the time, you can't even tell what's going on. It's a wall of text and black and white activities. Nobody can use this schedule. Even the person that creates it after 500 activities, it's a goner. You cannot get total participation with it. It is not a visual tool. Therefore, it does not comply with item number 5. Therefore, CPM is not lean. And number 6, quality and continuous improvement. This one right here hinges on number 5, which is the ability to see. Because you can't see, you can't improve, you can't make improvements to this. All you can do is rush and push and panic. And CPM's only answer is to crash the activity, add more money, expedite, get another crew, work overtime, none of which typically work. It does not comply with item number 6. Therefore, CPM is not lean. I could go into this in more depth. When you compare this to the theory of constraints, the 14 principles of the Toyota way, this is lean. Whatever framework you use, CPM gets a big F minus. CPM is not lean. I really hope that you can help me share this message. There's a longer video that will go through more detail on this. We'll link this in the description below in a blog post and a visual, but help me share this message because CPM is hurting us everywhere in this industry. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.